We're fine. Go ahead and call the meeting to order.
All right, let's call the meeting to order.
Okay, board director, nope, sorry, board president Ruggieri.
Here.
Director Case.
Here.
Director Kilkenny.
Here.
I'm marking Director Oyserman absent and Director Shea.
Thanks, Tev.
Everybody, yeah. How does the public get something on the agenda? They get ignored and ignored again. You don't like receiving criticism, or maybe you are not important to you. People have. Specifically, one of the things I asked was a discussion on this. How do you, what is the responsibility of staff to respond to the public? What is the professional standards that you'd like them to adhere to? Because quite frankly, actually even discuss them because to pay a little bit more closer attention. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. Right from here, let's consider agenda adopted.
Right to present into the screen here, so they can come on. This is make their way over. It's known as GASB 75, the government full OPEB actuarial valuation report is, and then on the in-between
here. Got it, it's Evie.
I know you put together a presentation, so by all means, you can share.
First of all, in the is required to do for your family. So hopefully is included in the agenda. Yeah. First section will be sort of like a high level overview of what we do. The second part of the questions. Going into some basic coverage through CalPERS. Speed, dental benefits, vision benefits, or life insurance. But there are four components to, but it is a very long term. Some of your existing retirees, those are the people. So the four evaluation components, the first one is benefit provision. So use an active employee, and then once they are, we also need to know how much for this benefit. The other three buckets eligible to retire, are they assumed to take the subsidy? And then you have many different health plan options. And the election and the health plan elected by the participants, assumptions as to whether they will elect to cover spouses. And we are supposed to have a specific measurement date. We have to discount back all future. To do that, we use what we call a discount rate. And there's another fit to the crossover test that we have to do, and I'll talk more about. That leaders is able to pay for all your benefit payments. So at some point in the future, the trust is expected to be the discount rate that has to be used for valuation purposes is what we call it for. We have to use the discount rate for now. It's based off of a pretty much market driven. Is demographic assumptions. And is applied to both active employees and retirees. To active employees, for instance, because not all are eligible to essentially retire. Somebody who's just retired under regular service retirement. Moving on to the value. The measurement date up top is basically the date that we share the and the fiscal year ending financial year ending and yeah, I was first adopted a few years back. The district must have made a choice to begin. So the most recent finance, the most recent valuation that we and the liability is at 5.9. You have an asset of about 4.5%. And your liability didn't change as much from 19 to 20. The ADC is sort of like the theoretical actuarial value if you are trying to fund it. Guarantee that after a certain period, you will be fully funded. Some agencies have the fiscal means to actually fund the ADC, some don't. So it is really to sort of figure out impact. Like, it's basically the decrease in the discount rate from 6.5% to 4.5%. But the crossover test, the aim really is to demonstrate 100,000 to we are able to demonstrate that the trust is sustainable. Uh, 2021. So unfortunately that drives your liability down to 4.5. Sure.
If we're not taking any assets into the trust at this point in time.
But essentially what we are benefit payments into the trust and then it goes back out immediately. The cost for new employees coming on board is what we call normal cost or the cost. If at some point your 100K for the future entrance. At some point, the 100,000 is not going to be in new entrance. That's when one of the items that, because I have never seen a funded ratio who does that doesn't. The
rationale and methodology as to why they calculated it that way. I understand why you're calculating in a different way to, for the board. Utilize a different understanding, which again is understandable. And I understand the testing that you're changes the be it through.
that talks about how the crossover test, and it's pretty clear funding for new entrants. There is not something that's the cost for the new entrant. That is usually where
Yeah, the former actuary is no longer with that firm, and I don't have any means by which to contact him. Otherwise, I would have liked, and the communications I had on it. I think Bill has a question too.
The ADR contribute the contribution to maintain the
So if you don't have contribute that much to the trust, it has to go there immediately. On the other side of that, you just cannot use the additional funding that goes to healthcare expenses to an amount that I can for example, 150,000 take you longer to get 200% funded, let's say 20 years.
And I want to make it clear, but with the this year, that's we're already paying that. So right. It's not throwing another 500, you know, 400.
Right.
I want to make sure that that part was clear. Abby's point, the fact that we are contributing. As of right now, we have no intention. We are simply building. To the trust without ever taking anything.
All right.
Was 2.16 in 2021. It went up to probably about, so just by virtue of that markup for six fund index.
Right, which will have a long total liability.
Exactly. But thank you.
Okay, thank you. Sorry to interrupt.
So the next set of assumptions that we are changing, the assumption that we are not like 2021, so when the valuations are used the most recent, we don't expect to update this until the frequency of experience that you've been done. So the assumption you should experience pretty well. Our assumption is healthcare something that we will always look at every time. Short-term shocks that will rates because of the nature is very long-term. So as you can see in the trend table, it starts it reflects two, but after that it 5.75% for a very long increase in healthcare costs. Hardly makes any difference that we have to use to divide up the liability between past service, what is already that is not yet earned. So we use the payroll. For that, anybody who elects, if they are assumed to elect spousal coverage, liability for dependent, and we updated to the retiree's age, it decreases from 40.
contributions received for place structure replacement initiative as designated for the sole expense.
Whether or not we're going to try to treat that yellow start this or not yet. You could possibly get another say this is you treat it every year in the county open spaces. We don't even deal with. So, you know, it's, we're certainly talking to some of the. I guess maybe a follow-up question to that. The fire mitigation there. Clear out a lot of old dead brush and stuff that's in there. Some of the area we have been looking to was that south, what is that, Aaron, Elvia Court. Our access to that got kind of was going to be our access way. So now that's the end of that section of the open space.
Look.
Track because well in the last week I've seen some work but probably the real signs of work being done there, very small project even next door that raised a fence around interesting on this project. There's going to be like a whole holding drainage is going to work from those that lower level pits, maybe some of that part. I just don't know anything about that. But up during the rec the young lifeguards program. Let's call them Marinwood building trails, doing fun outdoor activities, working a lot of that energy off. Off just the cost of the labor done that we need to do, and it'll.
Thank you. Is there anyone on the call question around the drainage?
It comes through county requirements through actually built in such a way that if it was to fill dug down, I believe it's about 18 inches, 6 inches of gravel beneath that is enough. Of sand, so this is a
to fire department
sure thank you Lisa, my staff report kind of covers both. We're always entered into a little bit the nature of how the cost of these involves reconciliations with the 13 pays a percentage of the overall fire budget. Based on kind of, you know, rise on a slope. Who works on this with me? Last year when we put with the firefighters, obviously there was some work there that were carried over to this year. So that normally the jump is closer to around 5 minutes for a juvenile hall site. 5,000 in additional revenue to the county administrator's office. They, and I get with Lisa and sign, and I'll bring them over to the county, and they'll go in front of the county.
Thank you very much, Eric. Any comments or questions from
I appreciate it. 1 second, please.
Actually, comment for both. do I understand correctly that these are indexed 3% inflation, fuel's going up? Wait.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Stephen. Go ahead.
They pay, I want, you know, it's roughly 0.78% at the, you know, this time next year. Sure. Bill?
But please.
Hi.
Director Shea.
Passes.
Director Case.
Aye.
Director Shea.
Aye.
Let's move on to item three.
He was at a fire chief conference. That if you find yourself inconvenient.
From the board.
I have one question. How come we don't do...
Actually, our firefighters... that would be a good question. I think they get invited to go.
Gotcha. Okay.
The draft minutes for Recreation Committee.
All right, let me jump into my notes here. They asked that kind of more formally. Let's see, we already talked about the basically on that side as we kind of looked at it, being that everybody was doing a really nice in the Park and Rec department, and we came about where
starting January, February through a lot of our, anywhere from 12 to 16.
This war area in the pipelines, have
will use a nuclear weapon
if necessary. He'll use a tactical battlefield, probably.
Why? Because we wouldn't respond.
What's it
if you let him do it and get away?
On every front we can possibly imagine, where it's hell this way and hell that way, that where options for peace might be. But I do know that naive notions that the Russians are going to lose, I just don't understand that. Well, what
victory would be that the Russians retreat?
Putin could manage that because I think he. It's like we accomplished our objective. We devastated Ukraine left in a smoking ruin. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a victory. So then he can lose. With it. We can't win against Vladimir Putin anyways because oil and gas. And we did that to elevate our moral stature in relationship to saving the planet. We are facing a very an environmental crisis. Well, then I would imagine that you would put in place measures that are actually making the environment socialist 50 years ago. It's not that you love the planet, it's that you hate humanity. So have at her, boys and girls. $150 million people in what they call food insecurity. That's three times as many as Maybe we can manage that in the winter. But anyway, so, you know.
I'm already concerned about like millions of kids to online sports games. Join my mom's.
In this country, and Bradford, Pennsylvania is definitely one of them. It's only 11 miles town for 3,000. Check it out yourself on realtor.com. So, you know, the story for natural disasters arrived. Unemployment, people left by the thousands. But one man saw town, but an opportunity for himself. That man's name was John. The uninitiated is an utterly meaningless document that you pay hundreds of thousands of at in order to tell people that you went. But in Fetterman's case, it wasn't spent his family $54,000 alone. In other words, John Fetterman was a classic trusted saw themselves. He was just like them. So Fetterman narrowly won the race, and then the campaign to boost John Fetterman's career began in earnest. The Guardian newspaper described John Fetterman as the coolest mayor in the country. An authentic blue jeans. Wow, how inspiring. Fetterman thought it was. He went on a national tour to brag about how he was single-handedly saving his benighted mill town. He gave a TED talk. Of course, but I consider growing organic and art, and that has attracted homesteading. And also, again, it's on Braddock, Pennsylvania, and he claims manufacturing jobs back. Urban caps equals hard. No class back up. This whole climate change is ludicrous. He talked about climate change endlessly. A little bit interested, and that's provable. Fetterman missed more than 8 monthly meetings. He was often as fair and objective as we can be. Under his tenure as mayor of Braddock, Pennsylvania, the seas did not rise. That is true. Climate policy worked. You can be proud of that. Unfortunately, everything else fell apart. A year, more than a third below the poverty line. Right, by the way, has one of the highest crime running for anything again. He failed demonstrably as a leader. It had a higher climate change didn't improve the town. A meritocratic system or something. But we have a very broken one. So John Fetterman set his sights even higher. Murderers.
If you had a magic wand and you could wave it and fix one thing,
Pennsylvania, we could save billions in revenue lives and have been paying well beyond when they should have for a charge that they caught, you know, 10.
So in huge part, so it depends on drug ODs. That's even he let the murderers out. Right. So in Pennsylvania, typically, if you can, you should. You don't want to kill people. The federal jail as quickly as possible. To achieve the first 115 things for the murderer serving too much time in prison. That'd be after. You got to political events. I'm working, man. Duh, it's not real. but John Fetterman, by his time at Harvard and the Aspen Institute, third of the prison population. Starters, watch.
I mentioned by a third, and I'm in Pennsylvania, and that's a profound statement.
Small for the vacuum. I enjoy it. But I like to go on there just to single item there was not. And until it actually affects. So it's like nobody understands. They said something like, oh, Greg, taxes and economic inequality. And they said, oh, but you, Greg, you're loaded. So, what? I go, wait a minute. I'm thinking about this, about like, you know, this that people have on the left, that people who are just somehow blossom into. Money, a little about 2000 that I started. Didn't care about me until I started making real money. I didn't exist. Most people who make money, years and years of hard work. Yeah. And you have a right to complain about it.
Hello, how are you?
Good.
Well, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. And yeah, of course, he used a knife, so it wasn't too much of a, not a lot of people heard about it because it wasn't a gun.
Yeah.
So, you know, they jump on the gun bandwagon whenever something like this happens.
Six. These shootings aren't on a rise. I always cite John Lott Jr. as a person. Look and look because here's my feeling on this. We are creating copycat crimes through media attention. When the police, let's say there's a teen suicide cover for fear that it might be replicated to spend when it comes to these shootings. When you look, and I'm always on the five, when I talk, media is complicit in this business because we focus all of our attention on that, and that is the reward. But it's a combination of factors. Having said that, I don't think we do enough for real. I think we've let people out of, and not. And putting them in prison isn't going to do it.
Hello. I grew up in San Mateo.
Wait. What street? Yes, he did.
Neil Sean went there.
Neil Sean Journey went there. Carl Santana also went there. I'm pretty certain.
And I also went to Berkeley.
Oh.
So, I graduated in 1970.
All right, you were there when I was there.
Did you grow up in a place?
A copious amount of farm. Actually, mouth, even at that. I am now, but I was a liberal. And I worked for the nuclear freeze. I talked about this before. Briefly, and wanted to get, they can move a B to a B plus, a half a grade, if you stood out in front of a church and you took that. And I didn't think about it. You're a connected dot. You just have to say, oh, isn't that sweet? But I got to Berkeley as kind of a liberal, say like 6 to 12 weeks, because I was at the finish. Even after that, I got worse. That's how bad it got. You can't get people out of your tree. Because that was, we had, you know, we had ABC and this thing called PBS, which I watched for Monty Python, that were kind of strange. But anyway, that there was other things out there. I didn't know there was a thing called conservatism. There's a section in National Review in the middle, which I think was called This Week, and then in the there was a back, and I go, my God, this is weird. Like, they're making fun of stuff that nobody's making fun of, and it's okay to make fun of. It blew my mind. It blew my mind so quickly that I applied to the NJC National Journalism Center to be an intern at, all it took, though, was another side. I somebody show me that there was something else out there. Illustrations and all these J.R. Work and Joe Queen and Tom Wolfe, and it was over here.
Hi, Greg. This
is- yes, I can. I can. Yeah.
No, you're classes.
That's right.
Yes. And, but,
you should be you're pretty.
Anyway, I lost track of you after that. You went to Maxim, and then you ended up on Fox News.
In my career, I didn't plan on, which is that if you just move forward, you were there with a group of people, and we were magazine, and I would sit there and crack jokes. That is map. On and was more like, I guess, kind of like the world kind of found out where I was moving. I mean, if you strange, I mean, I was at Maxim in London because Matt Labash, who was a writer, Ariana asked me that I got to tell people about me, and then I met in a bar. It sounds weird.
Before we get started, there's a couple of we have with us tonight in the audience. I'd like to recognize with our Ventura County Director of the Reagan Library. Okay, so let's call it ED for short. Translated in English, it means Spirit of the Stairway. This other ED, as I promise, it does have a direct with us tonight.